It's invisible, it's intangible, and it's very dangerous.
I totally agree.
I've never seen a green monster. I've never seen a monster of any kind. But this is a monster. A real monster. Not one out of a book or a movie.
A family claims it's terrorized by invisible demonic forces. A house so evil it requires a full investigation and possible exorcism.
This monster can take a family and destroy it quicker than anything else, and that's its desire. It loves to destroy anything good, and family is good.
This is Carmen, mother of four children, wife to one husband, and victim of her first paranormal sexual attack.
It physically engulfed me. And every night since, I've been under some sort of attack. The next night, I was sodomized. The following night, I was raped. My husband's been sodomized. My husband's been taken into a deep trance and showed horrible things. I was sodomized doing dishes.
But it was her niece Tammy that first aroused the interest, sexual or otherwise, in their resident entity.
Something was just grabbing at my bra and pulling it down. And I would pull it back and it was like pulling a strap here down. And it was pulling the whole front of it down. I kept pulling it back. And I got scared. So I rolled over onto my stomach and it stopped then. And then it like felt like something had picked up my covers down below the bed and just like gradually come up and just lift my nightgown up and touch my back and just like split up my back and back down.
And these are the Warrens, a couple that have followed the trail of the paranormal wherever it has led them over the years.
What we're saying here is that in many homes that are haunted funeral homes, that necrophilia was performed. Necrophilia would be abuse of the dead bodies. Now, we're not saying that the owner of the funeral home did this, but it is a door that could have been opened up.
The former funeral parlor in Southington, Connecticut, was occupied by Carmen's family for several months before she began to speak publicly of her experiences. She claimed she was unaware of its previous use. Since then, an investigating team had been brought in, and a diary of events has allegedly itemized dozens of inexplicable and amazing phenomena.
On the bed, it's kind of strange because the thing is heavy, but it has these little tiny feet, almost like goat's feet. But when it sits next to you, it feels like a 200-pound man sitting next to you.
Apart from the family and the investigators, there have been no other witnesses to these phenomena prepared to speak publicly.
For one thing, you have to realize the area that we're entering, all the trappings of the funeral home are still very much intact. This chain body hoist, this lift right here, that the coffins were put onto and brought up through this trap door that is above us into what is now the master bedroom. While my husband and I were in the master bedroom, I would say probably around 3 o'clock in the morning last Thursday, we listened as that kept turning. And there was no one, absolutely no one, was down in this area. And then the floor, right here, this floor, which is in the master bedroom, began to rumble. And at that moment, I believe it was Carmen who said, "My bed is vibrating, my bed is vibrating."
By this stage, some of you may have found this a familiar story, and the clue, the use of the word entity, by both Carmen and Tammy, both of whom admit their affection for the movie of the same name.
Well, have you ever seen the movie Entity? It's more or less like that movie, yeah, but it doesn't care. You can be standing and you're raped. You get raped right then and there.
In this film, Barbara Hershey's character is attacked almost identically to the description by Carmen of her own experiences.
It'll walk all the way around your feet, walk up next to you, slap you. And you can have your arm in front of your face, and the slap can go through your arm and hit you in the face.
That was the very same night that I had been watching what we call ghost lights.
Oh, yes. It's told me it will kill my daughter. But it's told my husband it will kill our son.
Why haven't you just taken your children, which must be your most dear concern, and left this house?
Where would we go? Children need stability.
Even if it's going to kill them.
Hopefully it won't kill them.
Hopefully good fortune will smile on this house in the near future. But why would a mother suffer such indignity and personal risk to both herself and family? Why would researchers spend weeks at a time covering these events in minute detail? Well, one answer was offered by a very irate and outspoken upstairs neighbor who's had just about enough of the ghost stories and let us know in no uncertain manner. She later calmed down to clearly express her views on the supposed haunting.
They claim they didn't know it was a funeral home when they moved
in. That's totally incorrect. I work at the real estate place where the owner of the real estate place also owns this house. And these people are well aware. I worked there during the time when this woman came to rent it. She was totally made aware that she was told that this was a funeral home.
You're also saying there are difficulties with the rent?
That's correct. They're back 2 months and this month was not paid. She let that statement out to the paper too, to a reporter.
What possible purpose then has this manifestation
Money.
Of ghosts?
Money. Money. This all started out when the woman downstairs was having nightmares. She told me she was having nightmares, and I said, well, Carmen, I go, maybe you need just a sleeping pill or something. She goes, no, she goes, it's evil. She goes, it's my father. She goes, he's coming to haunt me. I'm calling the Warrens. And
how did she know the Warrens?
Because of some woman at work told her about the Warrens.
Okay. What kind of experiences have you had?
None. None, no rapes, no sodomizing, no hands, no black shapes forming. We did have a light go on and off. That could be a light bulb. Why isn't it? And I was going to swear that why the H isn't it upstairs? Why isn't it?
At this point, I asked for the name of a priest who the Warrens claim had visited the house. We wanted to speak to him as an independent source.
There is no priest. There is no this. There is no that. What is this? Because of this nut up here almost ran you down? Hey, this is baloney. Come on. Let's get out.
I'd like to discuss it some more if we can.
Yeah. I'm not discussing anything any further.
I think your credibility is
in the
stake
here. I don't care about credibility, pal.
We contacted the priest named. He wouldn't appear on camera, but said there were no plans for an exorcism. He did say, however, he felt a strange pressure upon entering the house.